Talk to
Let's
me
hop across the pond.
Oh, yes.
And go to Ed in the UK, who might be able to help, I believe, the person who couldn't put their email address in when he wanted to order a pizza.
Yeah, that was the weirdest thing.
I think that's the one he's addressing.
His email address, he would start typing just the first two letters. It would say invalid.
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 Like,
can't
no,
do it.
It's my email
what?
Address.
Wait. And it would work. it would work on some sites, not on others, but it was different computers it happened on. So we know it wasn't the computer. It was very strange. Well, good. Let's see what Ed has to say. Thank you, Kim. Hello, Ed. We're in the UK.
Down in Gosport, which is near Portsmouth on the south coast.
Very nice.
So you went to Southampton on your cruise trip once?
Yeah, I've been to Southampton. Yeah, yeah. So you're near the White Cliffs of Dover.
They're a bit further along, but kind of that general area.
Yeah.
Relatively close compared to where you are anyway.
So, Ed, have you had this weird email thing happen to you?
Well, I've seen there's a kind of growing trend on some websites that I think this, I think it was Mike, might be experiencing, where you start putting in some letters of the email address and it says invalid email address straight away.
It's exactly what happened.
Two letters in, so it's not a valid email address at that point. And he said that if he pastes in his entire email address, it works. So I think what he's experiencing is just these websites where it says it's invalid until it's valid.
Oh.
All he has to do is just have
keep typing. Just keep typing.
Yeah. And keep typing until he gets the whole address. And I think it should work.
Why didn't I think of that? So I understand it because, and you might be a little bit of a coder yourself, Ed. It sounds like you understand what's going on. When you type things into forms, there is code, JavaScript usually running in the background to make sure, you know, it's a real phone number. You've had that experience where you type a phone number and it says, you know, hey, don't type the dashes or do type the dashes or too many letters, things like that. But that ideally runs after you complete the form. And it sounds like these sites are checking every letter as you type, which is a bug. That's a bug. Yeah.
I think it's just a growing trend to sort of, now you've got Ajax and things to try to do things on the fly.
Right.
It's doing it and it makes it.
I never really thought about how would you know that the person has completed the form? I guess when they tab or click on the next form, then you can validate the form you just filled in. That would be the right way to do it.
Yeah. But I have seen quite a lot of websites now where it says invalid until it's valid.
The whole time. But no, you know, that now I'm saying it's a bug, but maybe it's intentional. It just seems like it's a bad idea.
Yeah, it's probably not the best because you do get users that might not understand that if you just keep on going, it'll work.
Ed, thank you. Yeah, you were sitting there listening to the show last week and going, I know. I'm glad you figured it out.
Put it on the Tech Guy website for an answer for that anyway, so hopefully...
Oh, thank you. Bless you.
Tried it, but,
well, I appreciate your listening.
Well, and I appreciate your podcast. I've been listening since about 2007, so it's nice to say thank you personally anyway for...
Wonderful. Thank you, Ed.
All of those.
Nice to meet you. Next time I'm in Southampton, I'll wave.
Southampton.
Wave at Gosport. Thank you, Ed. Take care. Mike on the line.